Hi, I'm Sam.
And I'm Gus.
And today is part one of our three-part video mini-series about the Common App personal statement essay.
Dun, da, da, da. Dun, da, da.
All right, so this is one of the most momentous essays that you're gonna write during the college application process, essentially.
I would say one of the most momentous of your life.
Potentially, yeah. This is the personal statement that tells an admissions officer about who you are as a person, the obstacles that you've overcome, and tells them about your character. For most of these schools, you're going to be writing other shorter supplemental essays, but this is really the core essay that tells them about who you are, what your character is, and how you want to tell your story. The common application prompts, there's a few of them, but they're pretty similar, and essentially you can decide first what you want to write about and then decide which prompt best fits the story that you want to tell.
You can also, if you don't feel like any of the prompts that they list, you know, really fit what you're looking to write about, you can make up your own prompt and write an essay that's a little bit more creative.
So here are three of the common application prompts. Some students have a background, identity, interest, or talent that is so meaningful they believe their application would be incomplete without it. If this sounds like you, then please share your story. Or another prompt, the lessons we take from obstacles we encounter can be fundamental to later success. Recount a time when you faced a challenge, setback, or failure. How did it affect you, and what did you learn from the experience? Or discuss an accomplishment, event, or realization that sparked a period of personal growth and a new understanding of yourself or others. The thing is, in order to write an effective essay response to any of these three prompts, you basically need to address something in all three prompts. If you're talking about a background, identity, interest, or talent that's meaningful to you, in order to communicate that it's meaningful to you, you need to show that you overcame some obstacles, and you need to show that that led to personal growth. And that's what leads to an effective story, which is essentially the first part of this three-part series, which is about the ideation and coming up with the story that you want to tell and making sure that it's a story that communicates something about your personal growth and about obstacles that you've overcame.
So ideation is basically just a fancy way of saying coming up with ideas for the essay. And this comes really easily to some people, and they're like, oh, my college essay, I'm absolutely gonna write about this very important experience. For other people, it's a little bit more like, well, I've kind of lived a big life. How do I narrow down what I'm gonna talk about?
And really what it comes down to is telling a compelling story, and a compelling story that reveals something about you and your personality. A useful exercise that you can do to sort of get the wheels turning on this is to think about your favorite TV show, your favorite movie, your favorite book, and what makes it a compelling story. At the core of what makes a lot of these stories that you find compelling is that there's a protagonist who's overcoming a challenge, and overcoming that challenge or obstacle leads to some sort of valuable and important personal growth for that protagonist.
For example, if you're writing about, oh, I won this really difficult tennis tournament, and at the end of the story, it's basically, I was really good at tennis at the beginning of this tournament, and by the end of the tournament, I was still
good rocked at tennis.
At tennis that I beat everyone else. That's not compelling.
That's not,
because yeah. You didn't grow at all. You're just like, I'm a talented person who continue to be talented.
So that's a good first step in terms of ideation, so that you can wrap your head around what it means to be telling a compelling story. Then start doing that for yourself. So just write down a list. There are no bad ideas at this stage.
I got it.
Gert, let's kill these motherfuckers.
Write down a list of times that you have overcame obstacles and stories that you think would make compelling stories, because as a result of that story occurring, you feel like you changed or you grew. Now there's an important difference here between characterization and character, right? Characterization, as you're talking about, say, the character of yourself, would include sort of a lot of just aspects about who you are.
Who are you?
You.
No, not me, you.
Yes, I am you.
Just answer the damn questions. Who are you?
Your identity, your age, the type of household you grew up in, the type of activities that you do outside of class, the type of academic passions that you have, the type of aspirations that you have, right? That's the characterization. But what you want is for you to tell a story that leads to saying something about your character, which is sort of more traits that you have. Does it say something about your bravery? Does it say something about your passion? Does it say something about your intellectual curiosity? So you want to make sure that you're telling a story that gets all of the characterization aspects of you, but then ultimately tells someone about who you are as a character.
I don't want you to tell us what you do. I want you to tell us who you are.
Also, don't feel like your story has to necessarily be about an accomplishment that you've pulled off. A lot of the best stories of personal growth are times when it wasn't clear that the person was like victorious at the end. It might have been a time that, you know, you lost really hard, or a time when you didn't perform as well as you wanted, but that experience led you to change how you behave.
So, Gus, what did you write your Common App essays about?
Let's see, I wrote one essay about when I ran for the student government presidency in high school, and I had been a part of the student government every year. I had been vice president every year, and I was like, now is my time. And then I gave this speech in front of the student body with a sock puppet, and I thought like, this is what the people want. And then I lost. I didn't even get vice president. I didn't place. I got fourth place of four people running. And I wrote about how that was a real growing experience. And I learned that you shouldn't be afraid to fail.
Right. So on surface, that was a story about Gus's student council campaign. It was probably funny because of the sock puppet aspect. He was able to sort of say a lot about his personality. But ultimately, what that story was more about is how you sort of, how your perspective changed at the end of that and how you realized that failure was okay.
How about you?
I wrote an essay about how in the second grade, I wrote a play called The Crazy Castle. I wrote a role for myself, which was Princess Britney Spears, and I did it in drag, and all of my lines were Britney Spears lyrics. That's tangential to the core of it, but characterized me.
Yes.
And then how I held rehearsals for my classmates under the monkey bars and how we performed it at the school talent show and how it like wasn't great, but ultimately what didn't matter at all to me as my second grade self, and then I extrapolated that into my creative pursuits in high school, was that it didn't matter to me what the product was or how well it was received, but I liked creatively collaborating with others and putting something together where I could get input from various people, and that was what was exciting to me. I loved working with other people and collaborating.
Well, it seems like on the surface, right, it's ostensibly a story about a young kid basically putting on a self-written production, which is funny, but more meaningfully, it's about the lessons that you took from that and how it taught you what is my passion in life is collaborating with other people in a creative way.
Boom, yeah. So that can sort of show you a little bit the difference between characterization and character and how you definitely need both. And you need one to inform the other. And as you're coming up with ideas for that essay, our examples could be helpful. You can find more examples online.
There's thousands online.
Yeah, or just list out experiences that you've had, or if it's more helpful to you, do what we said at the beginning of this video and think about protagonists in your favorite stories in literature or in cinema or on TV, and come up with a list and then sort of see where you go from there. In our next video, we'll talk about sort of once you've locked down what story you want to tell and what you want to say about yourself. We'll talk about good approaches for outlining the essay itself. So stay tuned, like, and subscribe so that you can watch our next video. And also, if you want sort of more actual one-on-one personal attention in terms of figuring out what type of stories you want to tell in your application essay and a lot of the other nitty-gritty aspects of that, click the link below so you can connect up with one of our academic experts. And they'll do it. All right, so until next time, I'm Sam.
And I'm Gus. Peace.